We're making squash soup. Summer squash.
Butternut squash.
Oh, butternut squash soup.
For those of you who are uninitiated, this is my sister Nancy with me.
All right.
And if you scrub it clean, because we're using the skin.
Okay, so a good wash, and I think Nancy washed the carrot, and we have some garlic and rosemary. When I make this, I'm just gonna peel that all off. Peel the skin.
Yeah, peel the skin. But we're gonna use the skin.
Oh, okay. Oh, the skin's gonna get used, all right.
It's, yeah, we're not throwing that away.
Are we gonna need a small pan? Let me get a small pan. A saucepan?
A saucepan, not too tiny.
This is the biggest one I have that.
That's perfect.
Okay. So this is what this looks like. All the cuts go in here. Here's the rosemary. I'll go get a bay leaf and I'll throw that in.
And we'll probably throw some garlic in there.
Are you peeling off the outside?
Yep.
Oh, you're gonna put the outside. Yeah.
This is ready to add water to cover.
Okay. We'll put this on the flame right away?
Put it on the flame.
Okay.
And you simmer it for an hour?
Hour! Yummy. Yum, yum, yum.
Then.
All right.
Then.
We're back.
What we do, cut that into some pieces. Cut everything into pieces now. Not too small, not too big.
Doing a. Oh! 5 second rule. Here, I'll rinse it off.
Do you want to rinse it?
No, you can. And then the onions too, right?
Me.
All right.
Yeah, onions, just chop those up as well. If we had a whole head of garlic, I'd put that on the sheet, but we're just...
Oh, I see. Just cut the top off and the bottom off and set it on the plate.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a variation when you're making this. Instead of just doing pieces of garlic, you take a whole head, you cut the top off and the bottom, and you roast it in here.
And then you squeeze it out like toothpaste.
I've done that before.
Yeah.
That's yummy.
But this will be fine. This is just another way, since this is all we have. I don't know if I've ever used rosemary with butternut squash, but I bet you it'll be delicious.
Well, we'll just have to say yum to the camera. Anyhow. So you'll never know, people.
And add S&P or just...
Oh, salt and pepper? Oh, okay.
And let's see, what else?
Just
pea?
Okay.
Do you like a little hot pepper flakes?
Let's heat it up. I like a little warmth.
And I usually use salt for the end when you touch, you know, you salt your own.
Oh, right.
Preheat the oven to 450.
Okay.
Convection roast. And then this will go for about an hour.
So you basically fork test it, and if it's soft, you're good to go.
Yeah, and you know, you want those brown bits, like we did with the...
the little bit of brown stuff.
Yeah, and like we did with the tomatoes, we stirred it in the middle just so that the other sides get brown.
Okay.
This browns up differently because it doesn't have as much liquid escaping.
Right, okay.
Like tomatoes
Do we add fluid then? No.
I don't.
Because you want... Well, roasting it is a dry thing.
Yes,
so
I don't add any fluid.
Okay, all right. All right, so now we're done now. So, all right, so this is gonna go into the oven for about an hour.
Hour!
Preheating at 450. And then we'll roast this and we'll be back once this is fork tender.
This is the stock that's being made.
That we're gonna use. So we're squeezing all the flavoroids out, all the flavor out of the cutoffs and everything, so they didn't go into the trash, they're being used. And then this is the roasted stuff, and we're gonna give this a toss.
At this point, I think we could even turn the oven off and just let it, the heat.
Finish them off?
Yeah.
Because it looks roasted, they
it
have
does.
Nice.
It's got some good color.
The corners have a nice little roasty, toasty look.
Yeah.
Oh so yeah, yummy. All right, so we turn
and
off
then the oven. We'll let that sit until we're ready to combine it all. Tammy does.
In gold mining, they call that a picker.
Yeah. There's a picker right there. You can pick it up with your hands.
He's our picker. Picker.
Yeah.
And a greener.
And you know what's really funny is this dog constantly looks at the camera.
Oh, she knows what to do.
She knows when the camera's on. She hears the when it starts up, and she immediately looks at the camera. So I can never catch her doing something cute. You know, she's doing something cute, laying funny. As soon as and it starts it up, she it's over. The moment's passed. She knows the camera's on. And so she's like, I'm
turn the camera on in a different room.
Yes. Well, I'm not that smart.
I'm kind of wonky.
All right. So many hours later, after a nap and other things, we have a broth, which we are going to strain. Nancy already told me what we're doing, so I'm just repeating it while she's doing it. So what we did is we captured all the flavor out of the cutoffs and the skins. Nothing went to waste.
And here's all the...
the yummies going in here. The roasted stuff.
We left it in the oven a little too long. But who cares?
Who cares? It's going to get blended and it's going to be wonderful. And you say anything else, you're never invited for soup again.
And then buzz this until it's the consistency you like. Let's just do a stir.
You blend till smooth. My sister also added miso paste at this time, which added a nice register of lower flavors in the soup. It was a great addition. We have squash soup going. This is the cashew cream that we made, cashew milk. There, I made a loaf of bread this morning. We are gonna toast it. We're gonna sit down and have lunch. So it's absolutely amazing how that cashew
sits up
and looks like cream.
Real cream. Well, it's cashew cream.
And all it is cashew and water. And then lemon. The lemon gives it that little bit of tang.
Yeah.
And that's really good. We went out and we had pizza. And both Jim and I, mm-hmm. you know, cheated. You like the...
I always like the heel.
I'll let you have the heel.
It's just my little...
And we both cheated and we had what was it?
Carnivore.
The carnivore pizza. And it's a really good pizza place right here. And... it was very filling, so I had two pieces last night for dinner, and then we ended up with two pieces left over from dinner.
Oh, this is really good soup.
Is it? Okay. Let's get in here and taste this. Here is the squash soup with the miso. You can see the color change. It's brown now. The white is a dollop of cashew cream and my fresh bread on the side. It was a wonderful meal. Absolutely wonderful memory. With my sister and Jim. I'm glad they came. It is good.